change. The creams. Yeah.
Northwest of downtown Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. Today we hit double digits, week 10, and we've got a good one in store as it'll be the Atlanta Falcons taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
You play this one overheating those. Longer.
Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Oh, Jordan Travis makes a surprise start.
Now a first carry here for Robinson. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Well, this defense for the Buccaneers very strong in that victory a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And they work this well upfield.
And I'll start the share screen for Kyle.
22 yards there. A first down.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
What the fuck?
On first and 10, it's Robinson. And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just 1. You look at this defense for Tampa Bay. They're going to need to be strong against the run in this one.
They're not an elite unit. They're not, as what you'd say, the top part of the league against the run. They're a solid group, though. They do a good job. What they're looking for in this one, though, is an elite performance.
Second and 9. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Completes this to Colton Dell.
Simple drag route here, lined up out left and tried to work his way back across the field. You probably saw the twitch there, partner, because I think you wanted to pull a little bit sooner. By the time he looked it up, defender was right on him.
Close your block.
Third and 2. Robinson will try to pick it up. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, in a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got a light there. They strung together a couple of first downs. Establish what they wanted. The running game.
Swamp creature back.
Their lead guy running it pretty well too.
Nigga, I just fell, bro. And there was never a swamp creature. Whatever you say. It really wasn't.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Back to Robinson now on first down.
Oh my god. Oh my god. God damn.
Falcons. Bijan Robinson. His 7th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Falcons are on the board first here on the road in Tampa.
You'd have to imagine for a team that's lost three straight games, scoring.
Sure, that wasn't holding right there in Kyle Pitts, but I mean, we move.
And also, it's a nice signal to the rest of the team. We talk about complimentary football all the time. So they've now signaled to the defense. No pass. Yeah, that was so scripted. It's not even funny.
That's just my rookie playmaker right there.
No, yeah. I don't know why the fuck they playmaker script those. Right like, there. It's so ass. They always like put the fucking. They always put the fucking kicker back like 10 yards. Oh my god, damn.
Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any.
You should have tear some niggas ACL for Rashad White. Make it realistic.
Bad move.
Bro, I forgot whose ACL he tore.
I know it start this drive in the air.
I think it was a good player. I forgot who
he finds his target. It's Evans. He'll be brought down on the
30-yard
line after a gain of six.
That nigga's ACL.
We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on your time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready.
I really wish Dean's audio was in that fucking video.
Or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown giving up.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. You talk about this Falcon defense. Now they come into this one down at the 27th position in the league, Charles, against the run.
God damn, 27.
Getting stronger against the run. And to me, it
all
starts up front. You've got to win the line of scrimmage in order to play against the run very well.
They just said it.
They're going to look to throw. They'll dump this one off to the right. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first.
Does Rashard White think he is?
Only a couple there, and that's going to make it fourth down.
A short game that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Oh, I'm
nice
sure.
Job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
Why?
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on
fourth down.
They
could suck my balls, bro.
They'll run for it. This is
I'm not even a nigga playing yet.
I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And that will force a turnover on downs.
It's statistically, it's better to go for it on fourth and shorts than it
so
is.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
Oh,
he'll
no.
Get that complete to Dell. Yeah, that's good for a gain of six, and it's second down.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Second down and a run by Robinson. What a great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and they'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. 66 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine's.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Bijan Robinson. With his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the
bro,
Falcons
why is this Nick a gay-ass running back?
So it takes him just three plays here to find the end zone.
Did you not just see that celebration? That nigga was twerking.
Yeah, they got the stop on fourth down, so I imagine the offense said to their defense, thank you very much for this great starting field position. And like you said, three plays later, they're in the end zone.
The Falcons are going to leave the offense out there. They'll go for two.
Popeyes is not good.
That is caught. He's got it. And the lead will move to 14 to nothing. Well, remember back to the first touchdown,
that fucking number.
The point after was blocked, so they decide to go for two to make it 14-0, but why not just 13-0?
Yeah, I feel like there's a shift in thinking that we're seeing in front of us now in football. Some of it's analytics, some of it's just different thinking by head coaches. They wanted to get back to level, decided to take a calculated gamble, and felt like they had a good play call for a two-point try.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
Ew. He made an ugly ass storyline in his head about brands.
The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession.
If I wanted that, I would have called you the hard
eye. This one on a two-game win streak, plus they come off the open week as well. So this is a team that has a lot of things working in their favor.
Oh, it certainly is, and let's face it, this team is playing so well. The worry now is that after a few extra days off, they'll be sluggish coming into this game. So I've heard that he spent more time in practice working what they call good versus good, starting offense versus starting defense. They want a fast start.
That's
this next game.
The truth,
there's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain there, 21 yards.
Down by 30.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. He'll look to throw.
Oh wait, they're down by 2.
20.
Wow. An inaccurate pass. That's crazy.
Oh, and my best fucking O-line gets hurt right.
Double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Bucks have got it back to within a score.
He also committed PI on that play, but I won't talk about that. The linebacker.
Following
the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off.
Yeah, that's the only injury I know.
Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to the knee.
Oh, yeah.
There at the 24.
Murder.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. In the midst of, well, let's just say a not-so-rosy losing streak. They've got the open week, though, coming up next weekend, so you have to think. There he goes, left side!
Damn, he just juked up.
Oh, no, Jocko's game plan is out the window.
Last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. He'll look to throw. Looking for London on the out route complete.
The best contested catch in the league.
Inside the 15,
pulled him down by his arm.
10.
I'm sure that's legal.
14 yards there on a Falcon first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
The first carry for Tyler Algier. And he's going to work this one
down. Oh, now we are down to the third string. Oh, boy.
Wait, what the fuck? How the hell did he get up with a broken collarbone?
We're gonna come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
And now Tyler Algier has a torn labrum. This nigga season is over. Who the fuck is that? No way, he just almost. Is that Jalen Hawkins?
Still in search of his first rushing touchdown of the year, but not on that play.
I just wonder if he has some frustration starting to build a little
bit.
Why is
Jalen Hawkins in the end zone?
Running has to stay calm, stay within himself, just let it happen.
That nigga's a city safety, not a fucking running back. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy.
And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Chris Wormley record his fifth sack of the season. When it is close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Niners third and goal now back at the 11. They'll drop to throw.
Hell no.
A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone. And now it'll be fourth and goal.
And that big game may just change the thought process here on fourth down. I think in the red zone, they might now consider going for it on fourth down.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Doll fucking Cam Thomas won't do anything.
Byron Williams has 1,000 rushing yards in 10.5 touchdown
on the year. And the Falcons' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out. I mean, they are on pace.
He's so much better than fucking Cam Akers.
I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be history in the making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens, although, like you, I have my doubts, but they are firmly in control of this game.
This time, the extra point up and good, and it's now 21-7. Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. From the end zone, here's Devin Tompkins. The lane opens here, he's past the 30.
No way. No fucking way.
And they are not going to catch him. He's in. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
That was a special return, and it happened. Because he's a special returner, he has to
this
have
has two running backs with torn labrums and
to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times when they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
You're exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, and if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
Second quarter now in Tampa Bay. It's the Buccaneers in control.
He's currently winning.
As they've got it as we resume action. McLaughlin now to kick this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are. But let's face it, partner, they can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first. That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense. Countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
Flushed out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. So try and shake and showcase the pass rush.
So this has been like a tennis match, isn't it? Back and forth. These offenses have their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game? Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. Well, he tries to force it in.
Picked off by Deion O'Neal. And this is going to be sick.
That guy's a 10th pick this year.
Charles, you can just see the frustration.
frustration on the sideline. Safe to say that's not how they expected this series to go. The ball only went one way, and it was backward into their own end zone.
Well, Jonathan, your insanity first quarter run seems to be over. And I'm missing my best offensive player, so.
They wanted in with a punt or a takeaway. They saw the takeaway right there, and it turned out to be a takeaway. It turned into 6 points.
Man's whole fucking team just fell apart right in front of his eyes.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some
experience. Oh, my God. That Linsanity run is not gone, bro. That's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. That nigga just stunning on you with fucking Jalen Hawkins, bro.
Great effort there. 79 yards. And the Falcons.
Who the fuck is that?
And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage?
Remember that ugly ass long name we saw yesterday?
The defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's gonna be very difficult.
Nigga just ran for one play. These days shows you should never get complacent. And like, it doesn't matter, you're fucking two running backs got injured. I guess you got a third good one.
This will come out to the 25.
This nigga just had 70 yards on one carry.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
That's good for a Buccaneer first to pick up of 12 yards. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. That's complete. It's Chris Godwin. He stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. The Bucs at 5-3 now on the year. They come in off the extended break from the bye.
And I think it was much needed as well because you play two and a half months. You know you're ready for some time off in order to get prepared for the home stretch. In fact, when they looked at the schedule to start the season, I think they liked where their open week fell.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? The play action fake. They'll look to throw. There's a short one taken in by Otten. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Here's a second and five. Looking for Godwin and he's
oh my God.
And he's going to have a gain of 11 to the 11 before
he's the fuck out of you.
First and 10.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here.
Hey, who's going to make a play for
nice
me?
First down, drive keeps moving.
That's sad.
Looking for Godwin again.
Hell
no. Once more. And in for Buccaneers touchdown. Chris Godwin, an 11-yard touchdown. The Buccaneers are an extra point away from evening this one up. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And we've got a tie game here in the back and forth first half.
to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Falcons offense at the line. Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 93 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
I don't know. I would try to, like, block shed the O-lineman. I got this dope.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
They'll look to throw.
Hey, who are you? And Vita Vea is injured.
A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Now Young Wei Koo for the extra point.
This has been no defense.
It's up and good, and they've jumped back ahead. 35-28. Touchdown. Here's Koo to kick off. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And the points, they have come fast and furious.
That's a good one,
Koo.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield.
Holding him drive-through is kind of crazy.
They were looking to throw, holding on a big right tackle.
It's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually gonna pick up a holding call.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. He'll drop to throw.
Got his man complete! Hell nah. Why was Kyle Pitts guarding him?
For real.
So the big play gets him across midfield now.
And it comes to the uniform.
Back to throw.
Hell nah. Nigga, you just gave him a hospital pass. If that was real life, that nigga would have broke all of his rib cage. Okay, so if you move the dash,
so from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
What's up?
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
No, not yet.
Where was open, man?
Just a gain. No, he wasn't. I was looking at him. And that'll bring up
second down. Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space.
I got quit mad enough in this game. I don't fucking blame him.
Hell no. And they take a lot of pride in
covering. What a nice play. Just gonna be like a commissioner now, or?
Yeah, he's doing this like every year.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Wasn't he like 5-2?
On third down, a run from White. And stopped
a few yards shy of the goal. How did he lose by 40 to fucking 3? That guy beat me once.
Brandon, I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL,
yeah,
a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out.
Rashard White, that's definitely a touchdown. His whole body's in there. Given three on the game there. Second if you don't call a timeout.
You know, when his offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow, and this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down.
White.
Will score. Touchdown. Where's the defense at in this game?
I don't know.
Looks like a college game.
No, it's not 70-0. Things are getting good now. We're heating up tied at 30.
Falcon.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks away.
Why?
You would want him if the Hydra won it.
From deep in the end zone.
And at
the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
I don't know if he did either, but I know he should have.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together.
Hell no. Oh my God. Picked off. Hey, I'm sure.
Bijan hurt. This is going to wind up incomplete. That's some closing speed there defensively because
that looked open for a minute. But that's great. Looked in the pain. Never gave up.
Converged on his man. There's been four injuries in this game. Two running backs, defensive linemen, and an offensive lineman.
Who even is, though? He fucking hogs.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
That's
bad. Married with it, boom.
Black ass nigga. Yeah, you were. You definitely were. 100% gonna say it.
I'm picky with my name on the side.
Like, my Christmas gifts to you is like 5 N-word passes.
Welcome back, Charles and I settled into the booth for quarter number 3.
Oh my God.
Did you just say black people are coons?
I swear to God, if someone fucking gives me matter for Christmas, I might need to fight them. No. I said if someone gets me matter for Christmas, I'ma fight them.
I'm gonna get a new butt plug.
Never. That guy might only be bean and that's about it.
And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an
what
even first half,
that?
All tied on the
score. Oh,
we got
a breakout game. Isaiah Simmons getting X Factor, boy.
I'm gonna be bean like I did in the fucking Super Bowl in Madden 21.
Jocko, you here?
Nigga, you better wash your hands.
The Tampa offense ready to Isaiah get their Simmons drive needs started. Three interceptions or three tackles for loss. Drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points tied on the scoreboard. And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player,
oh, I saw that.
All I'm thinking
is, wow, that was a terrible play screen.
Looking for more there on first down. It was reading up in an accurate pass. It's kind of crazy. Incomplete.
Ew, so coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there.
Dave could be a giant, but...
Here's
second and ten. Mika should also be a giant, but he
there's ACL.
Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion,
a
very short pickup.
Creeper, aren't you the one that announces fucking name like that? Aren't you the one that said Mika Parsons?
Back to throw here. And that's caught inside the 35. That's a 10th wheel route, actually.
I think it turned around. I think it turned around and threw a fucking another big play. Boy, both defense have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
I look a little Mahomey.
That's my line!
I haven't heard you say it.
I was waiting for the perfect moment.
First down, here's White.
Like
and he
good.
Edges forward, but only gets
shut
a
up, Chink.
Yards out of it, and it's second down.
Defensively,
we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets
no, that's
there
your line, too.
Is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path.
He just called him the hard R.
From the 25, here's a second and eight. They keep it on the ground, White again. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a first down at the Falcons' 18-yard line.
I gave this nigga
47 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Dog.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive
all right, weirdo.
Take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit. A field goal would get him the lead, but that's not
you
what
know,
they're
that
shooting
makes
for.
Me feel
so
even better now.
Down. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with White, but he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Steps away. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Partner just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
What the hell?
I play Tub D next week.
On second down, they'll run with White, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through.
All that size and beef?
A loss resulted.
Here's third and 7.
Yes, let's get it.
Black squad.
They'll go up the middle with White. And
oh,
he's just
I'm sure.
Short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches.
Or White.
He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way.
Shut your bitch ass.
He may not have scored there. Of course you're going to give it to him.
Yeah, if he projected 17 points.
Line of scrimmage, the 2. They can still get a first down if they just get a yard out of this on 4th and very short. They'll try and run for it. And this time he is in. Rashad White taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Buccaneers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score.
Oh, that's not the luck one. And it pissed me the fuck off. That wasn't I think teams are like I'm just breathing. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Like when you say the N-word. Like what up my team? And how you say what up my nigga?
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And this game was square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
I think Jock is like 0-8 in close games. Actually.
Flush to his right.
In one score game.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Like suggested trades and things like that.
Yeah, they're always like fucking mad lopsided.
Look a little Mahomes.
And that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on third down, how about him buying some time outside his
towards
pocket,
ACL.
Waiting for someone to come open, and when he did, he put it his on him for a big play and a first down.
Yeah, TJ took the lead for the first time today.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Able to find down. He's able to get this to the
Nora is coming home.
That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
I think the Falcons can get worse.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to.
They're looking to take
the
division this year.
They also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this game.
Oh my God, it's Gordon Hawkins.
They wind up losing a couple there. So behind the original line of scrimmage and now third and 8.
What the hell did Niggas have to lose? They could have eliminated the Falcons. Now they have a fucking chance. Just gotta hope the Tampa Bay just wins out. Not happening.
Yeah, Trevor Lawrence is out this week. And the luckiest fucking team.
Fucking sucks.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
Fucking bad.
Pressure too much. Down he goes.
Yeah, I mean, but it's Jake
Rodgers. Here's Brown.
Third, though.
And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team.
Bryce
two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away.
It'll be
called just a 22-yard punt. Certainly not what he wanted. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
Jalen Hurts.
Beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups.
AJ McCarron.
Scored a touchdown on their last time out looking to repeat that. Charles' defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
Oh, down with Mike Evans.
It's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind.
They smashed Mike Evans in jersey number.
Which side can step up in a certain Caleb owns 13, so.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Looking to throw.
What the fuck?
Throw on right, it's brought in by Otten. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside
Brock
the 40.
Bowers.
That one.
I wish I had Brock Bowers stuck up in Seattle, unfortunately.
Poor guy.
play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
I think Bean knows how to use them.
End your line.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
That weak ass handle on that fucking sword. Picked off.
Man, it's I'm sure.
I'm gonna call this game the K-Dot game.
Inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
This defense
is definitely reeling a little bit now. Back-to-back big plays given up. And you know what's all defenses talk about. How do you limit that? Instead, they got hit by a 1-2 punch those last couple of plays. And now they've got their backs to the goal line.
Here's White. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one.
I think Doug would have already hung him up.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least two, maybe three more shots from close range.
Second and goal from the one.
Going over the top.
Again, this is right. Mm-hmm. Again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up.
Keep forgetting to get a EBJ's goal line play in the playbook. Because I know what defensive guys are
thinking right now. Oh, fucking league knows it now.
Get to the ball. That means it might not be sound defensively. Touchdown.
Mm-hmm.
Rashad White. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
That's fucking ridiculous.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
That's unbelievable.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. The last series for a disappointing, forced to punt.
We thought it was Lamar.
Come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
When's Riddler coming in?
Riddler's in the doghouse, I think.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep the leverage, unable to keep people
alive. Oh my God, the Undertaker.
Fortunate just to get rid of him.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Eluding the pressure run. And an off-balance throw there.
Sure,
it's going to wind up incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he's fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Going right side is White. And he'll get this one down to about the 17.
They try to skip his way through the seam.
Second down.
Well, that's a pretty good drive starter right there. And I don't know, partner, if you're even thinking about sitting on the ball right now. They may just want to run their regular offense.
In plus territory, and as an offensive coordinator, you don't want your team to go into a shell, do you?
No, you really don't, because as soon as you take your foot off the gas, it's real hard to put it back on and mash it, because once everyone's emotions come down, hard to start them up again. So I think he may want to keep them cranking high right here.
It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
Give him four on the carry there and second and goal. And they'll run again. And he'll take it in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Rashad White taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Buccaneers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good.
Oh, thank God. I just fucking accidentally made my USB drive fucking fall out of my PlayStation.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off.
Well, yeah, that's why I said thank God.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. Now a crease.
Yeah, room to roam.
That was almost trouble.
Trouble back from one.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game is played.
No aura
out.
On the Falcons offense.
Continue on now here in this fourth quarter. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
That should have been a torn rotator cuff.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it.
Ooh.
Multiple players getting home for the 1 yard sack.
You can just see it in their body language. They're starting to see victory on the horizon. If it comes to
literally had to play three plays this game to figure it out.
Defensive line has taken charge and controlled this game.
What are you doing in
this opposing offense?
Yeah, man, he like didn't play in the fucking preseason. So.
Trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league. It's tough. It's got to be wearing on him.
He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A big play there on the catch and run, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
New big baller tonight.
Now a handoff up the middle. It's Hawkins, and for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Out to his left. Thrown across the field, and that will easily be intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker, and the Bucs will take over here at their own 12-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And now defensive
Jocko didn't hear no bell. You did not hear no bell.
Extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2 minute warning. They'll look to throw.
Jocko's playoff hopes are over. Kick off.
Partner, you and I have struggled with this for years. You've got the lead. Just take care of the football and burn some of that clock. But there's something to be said for not taking your foot off the gas as well, because you can never have too big of a cushion. That one, though, falls incomplete.
It's a 45-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and it will be Falcon football.
9-1. Not even a warning for the guy.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it's second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. From the 43, it's second and 3. They'll drop to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on.
That wasn't a pick right,
so
but
they take
go
the
off.
Flag and the yardage that comes with it.
Here we go. Here we go.
They'll look to throw here on first down. That's caught left side, the tight end Pitts. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 15 yards, first down Atlanta. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
On first down, he'll drop to throw.
Where's this one?
That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Back to throw now on first down. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Levante David. And the Buccaneers are going to take over at the 13-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept the throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here.
You know, Jocko, you played a good game. You did. It was, look, bro, it was very encouraging in the first half.
You know, Jocko, you did good. You know, you didn't click on a single time on defense, but, I mean, it is what it is.
He's doing better than next week.
It was very encouraging in the first half.
I might lose my turn now.
You know, defense was a little rusty, but second half pitched a shutout. Damn, my balls are sticky.
That's not a joke.
Drugs. Yeah, and then Algier got injured like three plays in. No. You ran the ball like I don't want to play.
Caleb Williams has superstar about fucking time.
Okay, fucking nice.
Can you not change your abilities?
No.
Are you serious? This nigga's got
I got the worst.
Like, what the fuck is
I got this? Homer and Bulldozer. Oh my
nigga,
god.
Nigga, you might as well have just gone fucking star, bro.
Dude, you gotta ask him to change that shit.
My nigga.
What is Homer doing?
Fucking.
And he doesn't have X Factor, so that's fucking useless.
Where's Schmatz?
Who changed the Homer one?
Oh my god, Houston is fucking destroying Dallas. It's 85-47.
Without Luka or Kyrie.
Yeah, Tim Hardaway Jr.'s fucking 6-20. Jaden Hardy's 3-16. A bunch of backups. These niggas are sweating so hard. Steph Curry 0-7. No, Jaden Hardy.
Is Algier playing next week?
Just would like to say both Big Ron's Jocko had it's when Creeper and Kyle joined the fucking share screen. I mean, I just play better than you, man. I mean, it's my Bucks.
Are we in Atlanta next week?